index finger away, so you have a thumb and index finger touching each other, like so. And if you kind of look and trace with your eye, you'll see, I'll be dead gum, I am a Mobius strip. There it is, right there. Okay. Now, down to serious business. Oh. The idea of a flat Mobius strip. Well, if you take a flat piece of paper and you make two cuts so that you get three strips equal, but you don't cut quite all the way across to the end, about 2 inches from the end. In other words, you make two slits so that you get three equal strips of paper, then you got an E shape. You make two of those, and then you lay them down and you put the ends together, and you take each set and you twist them so they got a half twist the same direction, put the ends together, and then you'll have a flat Mobius strip. It'll be flat over here. You'll go around the twist and you'll be underneath on the other side, like that. Pretty simple thing. But when you make one like that and you put a lot more strips, say you make one with 11 strips. I got one here that I made with 11 strips that's taken two pieces of paper and made these cuts. An inch and a half till I had like 11 of them from a single rectangular sheet of poster board. It was 11, 8.5 by 11, something like that, or 11.5 by 14, or something like that. But anyway, when you do that and you do like I said, you lay them down and make the ends so that they make a half twist. So if I'm over here on this side, and I go here, I gotta make that half twist on any of these elements come out over here on this side in flat land. Aren't the flatland people happy now that they have a three-dimensional universe they can actually play with from their own reference frame? Anyway, when you take this then, where you got these ends, if you bring them together like this, and you do that with the other end likewise, you get this, which is a Bernoulli shape. When you rotate it, it opens up, or closes as the case may be. See, we've got one twisted here. Let me fix that. It's the way I brought the ends together. It does count which end overlaps. Maybe that fixed it. Yeah. There we go. Nice and smooth now. Yep. get that iris effect when you rotate it. Alright, now then, the outside over here surface goes around and becomes the inside surface on the other end. And likewise, this outside here is this inside over here. So we have here something that when you enter it on one side or the other, you emerge on the other end, on the other side. In other words, if you go inside here, when you emerge through here, you come out on the outside. And that's interesting. Another thing of interest is the transformations you get when you rotate. Anyway, make yourself one of these and play with it. Boy, do you get a surprise when you cut it in half. See, when you cut it in half, you come into each element, you just come up so far, go over a little bit, and go down that element. You come out over here on this side over here, now I'm 2 in, cross over a little bit and go down this one, come down the other side and come out over here, alright, cross over here, cross this one down, come out on the other side over here, see, back and forth, all the way across, one side to the other, flipping as you go. I'll leave it to you to find the big surprise when you stretch it all out and count your loops. I made this one's got 11 elements in it. You can make one with 9 elements or 7 elements. And you got these collars that you can close on the ends like so. And then it becomes the Bernoulli Mobius. Why the Bernoulli? Because of the shape of it. It's like a Bernoulli tube. A flexible Bernoulli tube. Could say a lot more. But anyway, you could have fun with this by turning it into a capacitor, electrical surface. Another way to put it together, oh yeah, instead of putting it together as two separate loops, put it together as just one huge loop, like so. And then, you get something useful. See when you put the ends together like that? You get a funny hat. If you do it right, let's see, twist it first, and then reverse these elements, yeah, reverse one side like that, see, okay, now put the ends together, like so, put the ends together opposite of the way you would put them together the other way. I wish Gilda Radner were here. Anyway, you get a neat chef's hat. And you can cook up some really good Mobius stuff. So I see I've gone over time anyway. I'm going to have to cut some of this crap.